Good afternoon, everyone, and apologies for the late start. It is my immense pleasure to welcome you all here and to introduce to you the man who needs no introduction, Mr. Kunal Kapoor, ace Bollywood actor. Kunal Kapoor is the co-founder of Keto.org, Asia's largest online crowdfunding platform, which fuels a wide variety of sustainable causes, right from fundraising for startups to fundraising for medical purposes. Over the years, Keto has helped more than 2 lakh people start fundraisers and raise over 1,100 crores of funds for their causes. You will definitely have heard from, heard about Keto during the second wave of COVID as well. They've done some phenomenal work, but I will let Mr. Kapoor speak about that in his own words. So welcome, Mr. Kapoor, to Charcha 2021. Excited to have you here. To begin with, please, we would love to hear about your entrepreneurial journey and what motivated you to start Keto.
Hi, thank you so much for having me. And, it's always a pleasure to be on a platform like this and get a chance to share what we're building. Keto is something which is an abbreviation for Key to Tomorrow. It was started 9 years back. And the reason that we called it Keto and, we felt would be the key to tomorrow was because we felt like this was the democratization of capital. We felt like that was really important because capital was controlled by very few people and, most people didn't have access to these people. So if you could change that and if you could make sure that people had capital for their medical needs or their social needs or their entrepreneurial needs, we felt like it could be something that was a game changer. And it came out of a very sort of simple couple of experiences that I had. I was working with a number of NGOs and I found that these NGOs were facing numerous challenges. And I felt like if we could sort of bring these NGOs from being offline to online, I felt like they would benefit greatly. And the idea really was to build a bridge between people that can help and people that need helping. So whether that's an individual or an NGO, there's so many people that need help in this country and there's so many people that are willing to help. But somehow these people don't come together. And if we could, use the power of technology to bring these people together, it would be something that was really powerful. And I happened to meet Varun Sheth and Zaheer, the co-founders of the platform, and they had very similar ideas. And we decided to create something that was firstly transparent so that you would know where the money is going and how it's being used. And secondly, something that was very easy, where you could sort of log on to Keto and in a couple of minutes you could help somebody anywhere in the country in a very sort of easy, transparent way. So that was the idea behind Keto.
Brilliant. And that's such a tall order, right? Because when Keto was co-founded, I doubt we didn't have the kind of technology that we do today. So it would be really interesting to know what were the challenges you faced at that point when you were just starting out.
Well, there were multiple challenges, actually. First and foremost was, of course, we had to educate people, not only the people that were going to contribute, but also the people that were going to raise the money, because crowdfunding was not something that people had heard of. So we had to pretty much create a market where it didn't exist. That always is very, very challenging. You have to go out there, educate people, you have to create awareness. So that was our first challenge. The second was, of course, convincing investors, because you do need investment to build a business like this. So to convince investors that this was something that had the power to make a big change, that was actually very challenging, because nobody was willing to buy into the fact that Indians will give online for charitable causes. A lot of them also told us that Indians inherently aren't charitable to begin with. And we seem to disagree because, I feel like we give a lot of money, but we give it in very informal ways. We give it for religion. We give it to people around us. It's just that that whole sector hadn't been formalized. So there was the misconception that Indians don't give. Often also what happens with investors is that, there's a industry which becomes the favorite industry and everybody wants to invest into that at that point of time. When we were starting off, it was e-commerce. It was obviously not crowdfunding. So a lot of investors didn't want to come on board. And then I remember this very distinctly, and I've said this before, is that there was one investor that said something that really stayed with me. He said that, you know, look, I don't believe this is going to work in this country and stuff. And when we were leaving, he said, look, it's not important whether I believe in this or not. What's important is that you believe in this. And if you do, then maybe 6-7 years back later, I'll look back and I'll say that I should have believed in it then. And 6 years later, he invested in the company. That was a sort of vindication for us and for the whole crowdfunding industry in this country.
Brilliant, brilliant. And that's kind of what you want to build as well, right? Something that important. How much has this culture of, you know, asking for donations for personal emergencies, crisis, medical emergencies, education, how much has this culture sort of, you know, changed in the last in the time that you've been associated with Getto since you founded it?
Well, I think two, three things have happened. One is obviously there's a lot more awareness about crowdfunding. I mean, like I said, 9 years back, nobody knew that something like crowdfunding existed. Now there's people from tier two, tier three cities that are using crowdfunding to not only raise funds, but also contribute. So I think there's been a big sort of shift in that. The other thing that we've seen is, you know, when we were starting off, there was almost like an embarrassment and shame about coming online and asking for money for a need. But what's happened over the last couple of years is that you see people just like you raising money, not having to take loans, not having to sell their jewelry, not having to sell their property to pay for medical bills. And in crowdfunding, you don't have to return the money. So you've seen people like you who benefited greatly from crowdfunding. And which is why people feel like, you know, there's nothing wrong in this. There's no shame and there's no embarrassment. And a lot of people that actually contribute on the platform are people that eventually go and start a crowdfunding platform fundraisers when they're in need. So there's been a huge shift, I think, in the mindset where the initial sort of embarrassment and initial sort of sense of maybe shame attached to asking strangers for money has now disappeared. The other thing that we've seen, which is very heartening, is that a lot of young people have got involved. You know, when I was starting off, one of the things I often thought about was that the social space in this country was structured in a way where there was a lot of young people that wanted to help, but they felt like maybe this is not for me. You know, you need a certain gravity attached to be able to be part of the social space. And we've seen that change greatly. I mean, during the pandemic, we've had somebody as young as 10 years old that has started a fundraiser on our platform because she told her dad that I don't want to just sit around and watch. I want to do something. And she started a fundraiser for migrant workers and raised 14 lakhs. So we've had somebody as young as that, you know, come on the platform and say that, look, I want to make a difference and I want to make a change. And I think that for me is something that's very heartening.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So since you mentioned the pandemic, we'd also love to know, you know, what have your greatest learnings or your greatest challenges been in crowdfunding during the pandemic, or anything that you've, you know, learned or would like to share with us?
I think the one thing that I've learned is the power of the individual. I think that has become very, very clear and apparent. You know, we were in a situation where the government and the social sector were greatly stretched, and it was very difficult for them to serve each and every one. And we saw so many individuals step up, whether it was a bunch of entrepreneurs that came together. They raised 50 crores, and they not only raised the money, they also imported the oxygen concentrators, made sure that those oxygen concentrators reached the hospitals. We had 13,000 campaigns that were started during COVID. We raised about $40 million. And I think that was all because of the power of the individual. And it makes you realize that, you know, if the individual is empowered and if you provide them with the right tools and avenues, there's a great difference that each and every one of us can make. So for me, that I think was the biggest learning.
That's so important, and that's what we've been hearing as well. You know, the power of the individuals and individuals coming together during these tough times, and just supporting one another in whatever way possible, even if they don't know who it is they're supporting. It's actually been absolutely heartening.
I just want to say this is that, you know, we keep hearing about how we live in a bad world and there's so much, and you go onto social media and you feel like, my God, everyone's just attacking everyone. And, you know, there's so much of strife and hate and anger and all that. But then you come onto a platform like Keto and you see strangers from across the world coming together to help somebody they don't know. And every day you're sort of reintroduced to the goodness that is out there. And, you know, how many people are willing to just support somebody that they don't know just from the goodness of their heart. So it really sort of reaffirms my faith in humanity, you know, being part of the platform.
You and me both, Mr. Kapoor. On that note, so where do you see, or how do you see this goodness sort of multiplying, you know, in the future, in the next 10 to 15 years? What is your vision?
Well, I think, you know, we've only scratched the surface right now. I mean, we've now finally reached a place where people are aware about crowdfunding and are willing to use it. But as a platform, we are mainly operating in urban centers and urban cities. We've just started going into the tier 2 and tier 3 cities. We want to eventually get to the villages because I feel like those are the places where funding is needed the most. And, you know, we're building partnerships now in tier 2, tier 3 cities, starting awareness campaigns, speaking to people there, because I really feel like we'll only have made a difference when we've reached the smallest of towns and smallest of villages. You know, we live in a country where it's estimated that about 55 million people have been pushed into poverty only because they can't pay their medical bills. And, you know, very often people are left in a situation where they have to, like I was saying, sell their property and sell jewelry so that they can pay for their medical bills. So we are hoping that, you know, we can reach out to these people and we can get enough support from across the world and, you know, support from enough individuals to help these people. And I think that for us is the vision that we have at Keto.
Brilliant. And with folks like you at the helm, I'm sure, you know, your vision will come to life. No doubts there. Unfortunately, we are at the end of our session, so I will have to thank you on behalf of everybody at the Nudge and Charcha 2021 for you know, speaking about Keto and speaking about your journey, your vision. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. It was wonderful speaking to you. And I'd also request everybody that's watching this to stay on for the next session, because we have it's philanthropy and entrepreneurship. So this is one that you don't want to miss.
Thank you so much. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.